time now for everybody's favorite guessing game, What's My Line? Brought to you by Remington Rand, makers of the world's number one electric shaver, the Remington. Now, let's all play What's My Line?
And now let's meet our award-winning What's My Line panel. First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in the New York Journal American and papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Sitting on my left tonight will be that charming young comedian who stars in his own television show five times a week in the afternoon, Robert Q. Lewis.
To my left will be sitting the very lovely lady with the diamond heart. Incidentally, copies of that beautiful diamond heart are on sale at chain stores all over the country. Miss Arlene Francis.
And on my left, at long last, you will see a gentleman walking in that you will find out is 6.5 feet tall. No. 6 feet 1 inches tall. Everybody always thinks he's much shorter than that, but you'll see tonight he's a very tall fellow without the benefit of standing on the Random House books that he publishes so well, Mr. Bennett, Cerf.
Well, seated on my lap, of course, will be our omnipotent, valuable master of ceremonies, news analyst who has only one slight fault. He loves us to be wrong and misleads us all the time, Mr. John Charles Daly.
Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to What's My Line. We've been through a whole new process tonight, and it's kind of fun changing the front end of the program. We hope that it's as much fun for you watching the next half hour. We've got some real nice folks here to visit us. They have some very interesting occupations. And as Bennett said, I like to see the panel wrong, and I think we're going to make the grade tonight. We'll also have a famous guest challenger before the panel a bit later, but now it's time for you to meet the first challenger whose line has to be spotted. Would you sign in, please, ma'am? Ruth? Ezekiel? Right, ma'am? I think, first of all, we'd like to know where you're from.
Bombay, India.
Bombay, India.
That's right.
Well, you have come a long way to be with us, I must say. Real nice of you to make the trip, and I really don't feel I have the right to ask you to travel anymore, but the panel wants to get a closer look at you. So would you walk down there for me, please?
How do you do, Mr. Ezekiel?
How do you do, Mr. Ezekiel?
How do you do?
And now, Miss Ezekiel, will you come over here, please, and sit down next to me? And it's our practice to let the panel, since they have had a chance to know you, even though briefly, let them have one free guess as to what your line may be, and we begin the free guesses with Miss Kilgallen.
I think she's a translator.
A translator, Mr. Lewis.
From Bombay, I would say that Miss Ezekiel was a chutney chopper from Major Grave.
Miss Francis.
Well, I think she's an interpreter at the United Nations, too. I'm afraid I was with Dorothy on that.
Mr. Cerf.
I think Miss Ezekiel has been taking Gandhi from babies.
No. Actually, I must say, panel, that we did try to fool you tonight with Miss Ezekiel, and we did, because none of you got it right. We'll now let our viewers at home have a further look at Miss Ruth Ezekiel, and at the same time, we will tell them what her line is. All right, now the panel's going to have to work. Miss Ezekiel, do you know how we score this thing? Every time you can say no, why, we flip the lid here. All set? All right, Miss Ezekiel is salaried. With that, we will begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Miss Ezekiel, do you deal with both men and women?
Yes.
Do you work for a profit-making organization?
No.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Cerf.
Miss Ezekiel, are you in some way or other connected with government work?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Are you connected with anything religious or charitable?
Any... We'll have a small conference, we may.
Yeah.
When you were dealing with these men and women, do you speak to them?
Yes.
Do you...
She's very nice that way. She can talk to me.
I'm sure they enjoy it. Do you ever speak to them in a language other than English?
Yes.
Do you have anything to do with children in your work?
Yes.
Do you have anything to do with helping them?
Yes, I would think so.
Do you have anything to do with educating them?
No,
I wouldn't think so. That's 3 down and 7 to go, Mr. Lewis.
Well, if you don't help educate them, do you help help them financially in some way by providing them with food and board?
No.
You want to go on with the quick? We've got you.
No,
got you.
I know already.
You want 4 down and 6 to go, Miss Benson.
Is your hope to help them medically in any way?
Yes.
Are you engaged in the business of raising funds for hospitals for children in India?
Isn't that wonderful? No. That's $5.
Thank you.
Sir.
Well, Mr. Ezekiel, does the work that you do have anything to do with an international organization?
International?
Like the Red Cross, something like that.
No, I wouldn't think so.
No.
Thanks for that, like the Red Cross. We had some doubts until then. Thanks a lot, Bennett. 6 down and 4 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Well, now, you have something to do with a religious or charitable organization, so all I have to do is pick out the wrong one.
Mm-hmm. That's...
Mrs. Ezekiel just picked it out for you.
Dorothy, I don't think heard it, so keep quiet.
Maybe I'll ask something else. Are the people who are helped medically, are they ever grown-ups, too?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Are they in a country other than the United States, the ones that are helped, ever?
Every country wants their help.
Every country
wants? No, every country wants their help. You said, are the people that are helped directly by Mrs. Ezekiel in the United States? Other than in the United
States. Are they in any place other than the United States ever?
You said ever.
Mm-hmm.
Well, as long as you had it ever, you get your yes.
All right. Yeah. Do you have anything to do with research in medicine?
Not at present.
No, not directly, Dorothy. It would be just as a byproduct, actually. 7 down and 3 to go, Mr. Lewis.
Well, I'm just wondering, Mrs. Ezekiel, you're so pretty and young, and is there a certificate required for the type of work you do? Have you had extensive training and education for the work you do?
That's right.
Are you a doctor? Are you an M.D.?
No.
You are not.
Oh, thank you very much. That's 8 down and 2 to go, Miss Preston.
Are you a nurse?
No.
No, that's 9 down and 1 to go, Mr. Sir.
Well, that leaves me. We've ruled out United Nations. We've ruled out Red Cross. Probably this whole uniform you're wearing is just to mislead us, Mrs. Ezekiel. Is it?
No.
No.
That makes it so far to go. Actually, I think we did play a trick on you because you're going to be horrified when you find out that Mrs. Ezekiel's easiest thing in the world to identify, she's a dentist.
You don't need a diploma to have a drill?
It was real nice. Robert finished up by saying, are you a doctor of medicine? And that finished the whole question for us. That was real nice. I knew you were dead when he said doctor of medicine. Well, Mrs. Ezekiel, we had a lot of fun. Hope you did, too. It was nice to have somebody all the way from India in What's My Life. Let's see what you can do with a second challenger. Would you sign in, please, ma'am?
John.
Cora?
I was going to say, I was the first non-profit-making dentist I've ever met.
Cora Saylor. just so we don't leave any participles or anything else dangling, do you mind if I take care of a point just raised by Mr. Cerf? Miss Ezekiel works for the Guggenheim Foundation. All charitable work, non-profit. Terribly sorry, old boy. Now, is it Miss or Mrs. Saylor?
Mrs.
Mrs. Saylor, where are you from?
Cranberry, New Jersey.
Cranberry, New Jersey. Well, let's not get bogged down, shall we? Would you go see them? Thank you.
How do you do?
Hi, Miss Saylor.
Hi.
All right, Mrs. Saylor, will you come over here, please, and sit down next to me? You may know, I don't know if you watch the program or not, but you may know that the panel gets one free guess on your line on the basis of their chance to see you in that lovely orchid. And
We always begin the free guesses with Miss Kilgallen.
I think she's a school teacher.
A school teacher, Mr. Lewis.
I think Mrs. Sailor is raising her own navy.
That's bad. I take it back.
You can have it back, Miss Francis.
I think Mrs. Sailor is a policewoman.
A policewoman, Mr. Cerf.
I think she's even higher than that. I think Mrs. Sailor is the mayor of Cranberry, New Jersey.
No, I'm afraid nobody has it right. We'll let our viewers at home have a further look at Mrs. Sailor, and at the same time, we will tell them what her line is. But, Mrs. Sailor, you know how we score this thing. The panel's going to have to dig for this, and there's one additional bit of information that we wish to give to our viewers at home and to the folks here in the theater with us, one little bit of information that I think will help them. You all don't mind, I'm sure. Here it is.
What?
All right. And now, Mr. Sailor, you said you didn't know how we score this thing. I flip this every time you say no, all right?
I've watched.
You're all set?
Yes.
Good. Mrs. Sailor is salaried, and we'll begin the general questioning with Robert Q. Lewis.
You said it is to the audience?
What?
What did you say?
No, I said one additional bit of information. Here it is. I know we gave him that additional bit of information.
Thank you very much.
That's perfectly all right.
Mrs. Sailor, do you by any chance render a service?
Yes.
Good. Do your clients have one particular thing, some particular thing in common? Got a pretty hefty handshake. Is it their physical appearance that they have in common?
Well, I would say that this is a question with so broad an area that we would say her clients, as you have described them, are similar in physical appearance. But then unless, you know, you have six or seven extra appurtenances, you would be, wouldn't you?
Well, then, broad in appearance, you say. Would it be unusual for you, Mrs. Sailor, to go to work on someone like me?
Well, it would be. One down and nine to go, Miss Francis.
Oh, no, yes, it would be.
Oh, I'm sorry. Well, I tried.
I've been watching you at home, Mr. Daly. Well, then, is it safe to assume, then, Mrs. Sailor, that you work primarily or more often with the feminine sex? Do your clients weigh considerably more than the average girl?
Yeah, I think, Mrs. Sailor, to the degree that there is a declarable mean in weight, then I would say her clients probably are exceeding the mean.
And when you have... Well, what I'm trying to get at is this. When you have finished doing what you do with them, do they look an awful lot better in a bathing suit?
One down and nine to go, Robert. You'll see what we're all laughing at later on. Miss Francis.
Is it possible that these clients are not of the human race? Maybe they seem human to Mrs. Sailor, but is it the animal kingdom that you deal with, Mrs. Sailor, in your work?
Yes.
Are they four-footed animals?
Most animals are.
You've never taken a really good look at the panel, Mr. These animals, are they domestic?
Yes.
Are they animals that might be found on a farm?
Yes.
Do they give milk?
Yes.
Well, if you're dubious, it can't be a cow, because there's nothing dubious about a cow giving milk. Is it possible that these animals are goats?
Goats? That's right. No.
No.
2 down and 8 to go, Mr. Sir.
They're not goats and they're not cows. Is that correct? They're not cows.
Three down and five on the go.
Arlene, you got me in that.
I'm sorry, Bennett.
But they gave me an unfair, really an unfair trial, but they're too.
Yeah.
I look dubious all the time, Arlene.
No, you don't.
Yes,
you just framed it that time. Go ahead, dog.
Three down and seven to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Well, are these animals, these four-footed animals, of the bovine family?
Yeah, go ahead.
I believe that must be a Boston way of mentioning.
Well,
I'm not from Boston, but I hope it's true. They're so elegant up there. Do these animals have tails?
Yes.
Are they useful animals?
Yes.
Do they seldom wear bathing suits?
I hope so. Very seldom, I think, don't you,
well,
Mrs. Salem?
Yeah,
are they cows, little Elsies?
Yes.
Are they?
Yes.
She does know, doesn't she?
Yes.
Will you do something with cows, then?
Yeah.
Something unusual, I suppose, not just plain milking them.
Will you want like to ask the question, if is it milking?
No. Do you do something other than milking them?
Yes.
Do you do something other than raising them?
Yes.
Do you inspect them?
In a way.
Yeah, there's an area which would very loosely be called inspection. You go ahead, Dorothy.
After you've inspected them, do you do something else to them?
Yes.
Give them little pats. Do you vaccinate them?
Vaccinate the cows? No, that's right. Well, I honestly don't think you'd ever get this, and I'm afraid we have to close out on the basis of time. But this is particularly funny because 6 months ago, Mrs. Cora Saylor sat right here, and you all went right through this once before, and we wanted to see if you'd remember. She washes cows for Gordon Walker. Walker Gordon, rather. Mrs. Taylor was here 6 months ago, and you had a lot of trouble with it then, and we just wondered if you would remember, if something would come back into your mind.
Nothing
clicked. She changed her hair.
Same cows, same Bennett. Cows. Haven't changed the cows a bit. Well, Mr. Taylor, thanks very much. Hope you had fun. We certainly did. And I hope the panel will forgive us for playing tricks on them. But it was fun, wasn't it?
Good.
Now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery celebrity. My colleagues on the panel have blindfolds. Are they all in place, panel?
Yes,
John.
Good. Will you come in, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? Panel, as you know, in the case of our mystery challenger, we get right down to the general questioning, which we will begin with Bennett Cerf.
Well, we use our standard opening. Are you a representative of the entertainment profession?
Yeah.
I take it that delicate little voice comes from a lady. Is that correct?
Sure, buddy.
Would you be described in any way as a glamour puss?
I'll answer that one. Yeah.
The town is jumping with glamour pusses this week. They're here from new shows, new movies, new television shows. Have you ever appeared on television?
Yeah.
Is it an irregular rather than a regular appearance? That is, a special show rather than a weekly one? No.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Is this show, by any chance, going to be done this week?
No.
That's one down and nine to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Have you also been on the stage?
No.
Two down and eight to go. Wait a minute, small conference. Terribly sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah, we changed that one.
Oh, you have? Flickers?
Yeah.
Are you a comedian?
Nah.
Two down and eight to go, Mr. Lewis.
Oh, yes, you are. All right. You have already made your television appearance, is that correct?
Yeah.
Was it on this network last week?
Yeah.
It was. Was it a, what we call one of our spectaculars?
Yeah.
Was it the man who came to dinner?
Yeah.
Oh, now I've got to figure out which one of those beautiful gals we have here tonight. There were many of them. First place, the most beautiful of all, and this is not a question yet, Zazu Pitts. Merle Oberon and Joan Bennett. Now, that sounds to me most like Miss Oberon. Is that possible?
Right. Good deal. All right. Panel, we have just about 2.5 minutes, but let's see what you can do. Will you come in and sign in, please, for us, ma'am?
Well.
Ma'ams. Ruth. Ann. Ruby. Crawford, right? Okay, I'll get in the middle. Now, would you tell us all where you're from?
Atlanta, Georgia.
Atlanta, Georgia. Fine. Now, we have very little time, so just take a look at the panel. Let the panel take a look at you, and we go over here. Now, if I may, let me precede you, because we'll have to make these two chairs do, huh? Now, panel has had a quick look at you. We'll just give them one quick free guess as to what your line may be, which this is a custom of ours. We'll begin the free guesses with Miss Kilgallen.
I think they demonstrate twin egg beaters.
Mr. Lewis.
I think they supply the Georgia peaches, which the Remingtons shave so quickly.
Miss Francis?
Well, they're not Tony twins, so I imagine they play twin pianos.
Mr. Cerf?
I think Ruth makes cocoa and Ruby makes cola.
No soap at all. We will now let our viewers at home have a further look at the Mrs. Crawford. At the same time, we will tell them what their line is. Going to have to guess, and you have just 1 minute, panel, to see if you can lick this question. 1 minute and 1 minute only. You know how we score these? Okay, fine. We'll begin the questioning then with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Product?
No.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Lewis.
Service.
Yes.
And might a young man like myself make himself available at your place of business to have
one
services?
Minute.
1 minute? Oh. All right. I would come to you then to have that service rendered.
Yes.
Would you at any point did you work for a profit-making organization?
Yes.
Would you at any point come in contact with me physically?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
Are you part of the entertainment world in any way?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Mr. Cerf.
You girls demonstrate something.
Demonstrate something. Isn't that a wonderful question? Four down and six to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Do you purvey anything?
Purvey something. A physical... That makes it five down and five to go. Unhappily, our time is up. Ruth and Ruby Crawford, lawyers.
Lawyers?
Lawyers. Thank you very much. We didn't have enough time. We did all of this. Miss Dorothy is leaving tonight for Cleveland to cover the Shepherd trial. A very fine reporter and a top assignment. So until next week, this is John Daly saying tonight, good reporting, Dorothy.
Thank you, John. Good night, Bob.
Good night, Dorothy. Good night, Arlene.
Good night, my shepherd, Bennett.
Can't you behave yourself next Sunday? Good night, John.
Well, good night. Good night, ladies and gentlemen, and thanks for being with us on What's My Line.
This has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production, in association with the CBS Television Network.